Hi and welcome back. My name is Emily Hessler. Today I'm sharing a card featuring the Layered Pine 3 stencil set and also a stamp set called Winter Friends. These are products from Trinity Stamps. I will create a Christmas card using some bright colors. I absolutely love creating non-traditional colored cards for the holiday, and I really like how this one turned out. I'm featuring a technique, I don't know exactly what it's called, but I know I saw Jennifer McGuire do something similar like this, where she layered and trapped some colors underneath some heat embossing, and that is what we're gonna do today. So I removed the mask, cleaned off the mask, and now I will heat set this, making sure that all the ink is dry. Then I will put my mask back again, or the stencil here back. It will act as a mask here for my tree. And I will pick out some of the snowflakes from the Winter Friends stamp set, and I will ink them up with some Versa Mark ink, and this is a clear sticky ink. And when I have went over all of this, the whole entire image, I will coat this with some clear embossing powder. I think it's hard to see on screen here, but I actually can't see in real life where I have inked my snowflakes and where the gaps is and where I should put the next snowflake. It was one trouble that I have, and I think you will see it in the ending picture, was that it was kind of hard to stamp over the mask and it wasn't transferring the perfect snowflake. So the snowflakes that are closer to the edges will be a little bit splotchy, but I think they will definitely look like snowflakes. So you can see how it looks when it's all heat set. I will put my stencil back on to act as a mask again, and then I picked two distressed oxides, and I will go over this image. It's cracked pistachio, and I think it's lucky clover. I decided that the cracked pistachio was too light, and I will go over the whole image with that lucky clover instead. And when I'm done with this, I'm just making sure that I like how it looks. I'm gonna place my mask once more and then remove the ink that has been like layered on top of the heat embossing. You can see that it's actually resisting the ink that we put on top. I will put some brown espresso ink, I think it was down by the trunk, I think it's called, on this tree. On the outside of my card panel here, I will ink this up with some tumbled glass. This is also a distress ink, just creating a little bit of a definition, because we're gonna use a white card base for this card. And I think now you really can see how cool this looks. And that blue color really brings out the colors in that tree. So here you can see how that little color makes a lot of difference. I'm just placing some of the other stamps that are in shapes of presents, stars, and other embellishments that you can have in your tree, I should say. And then when I'm happy with that, I will actually go around and stamp some more snowflakes around this image using the same color, this tumbled glass, just creating this subtle snow effect in the background. I really like how that turned out as well. And for the sentiment, I'm going to use one that says, "Good friends are like snowflakes, all different and all beautiful." And I really like that, and I really like that this stamp set also comes with a coordinating dies for this sentiment, so I just can pop that up. And then I'm going a little bit crazy with all the embellishment, and I will leave links down below because I used a lot of them. I think this one is unicorn tears or something like that. I will leave links, as I said, but this is absolutely beautiful, and I think it really sparkles up this Christmas tree. And for the top, of course, I will use a star, and also you can see that white satin looking embellishment. I will leave links down below for them too, but it really looks like snow, and especially in real life, it's beautiful. So This card is pretty much finished, and I hope you like this project. If you did, please give me a comment or like or subscribe to my channel. That really would mean a lot to me. I will be coming out with hopefully a Christmas video where I'm showing you all the Christmas cards that I have been creating for this season, as I did last year, and I will actually leave a link down below for that particular video if you like to see 24 different Christmas card ideas from last year. So until next time, have a great day. Bye!